All right, first of all, let's talk about the end of regulation. You're three down. The only way you can continue this game is to get a three.
Yeah.
Did you kind of trick Noah into fouling you? Were you surprised? Because he clearly fouled you, right?
Yeah, clearly. You know, I seen the mismatch with Noah and me and the ISO situation. And just happened to foul me, you know. And went to the line. That's my first time going to the line in a situation like that.
Well, you're a good free throw shooter, but that's different, isn't it?
Yeah.
When you know if you miss, the game's over?
Oh, yeah, no, definitely. It's a lot of pressure, you know, man. But, you know, luckily I got, you know, my teammates backing me up and everybody believing in me. So they just gave me that ball in that situation.
You have 60 points in the last 48 hours, and you're really playing like Kobe. You've taken the Kobe role on this team. What's that been like for you?
I can't play like Kobe, man. Only one Kobe.
But you're taking his role on the team. You know that, right?
Yeah, Kobe's been a great mentor for me, and just telling me all kind of things during the game, you know. And that's been unbelievable for me this whole year, just learning from the greatest player to play this game.
29 last night, 31 more tonight. What's been the common denominator in these two games that's gotten you going offensively?
They said me getting texted got me going, but you know, I can't keep losing money, so I just been coming out there from the gate, just trying to have fun.
Where does this rank as far as being one of the toughest losses you guys have had this season, especially with it being so draining going into OT?
Oh, it's tough, you know, because I was sitting right there just looking at Taj go up for that layup. I was hoping the time, the scoreboard, I mean, the backboard was going to turn red before it went out of hand, but it didn't, you know. It was all battle, and, you know, they just got the, you know, they got luck on their side tonight.
Those three throws, the first one, it was touched just by every part of the rim. Once you made that, did it give you more comfort on the next two?
Yeah. You know, I went to the line thinking, like, okay, this is where big players step up. You know, that's what I was trying to do. And it's a blessing all three of them went in.
And then you also got the baseline jumper with 6 seconds left. Have you, and I'm not really familiar with the other 6 years of your career, have you had games like this where you're making all the plays in overtime and down the stretch?
A little bit, but not really like this, nothing like this. And I told you I missed the last one against Cleveland. And I'm just blessing that the coaching staff still believe in me. And Kobe was right there telling me, guiding me like a coach too from that sideline, telling me what to do and keep my head up after I missed the first shot.
Same with
those three free throws, that jumper, did either one of those rank as, you know, your biggest moment on the court so far as a Laker?
Yeah.
Which one does out of those two then?
I had to say free throws.
Free throws.
They were just, if I didn't make those, it was over. I was going to hear the end of it on Twitter or Instagram and all that. So, but just to be in that situation, I know most people don't want to be in that situation. And it was big.
You think that's the most pressure that you've felt in the NBA?
Yeah. And then after that second shot, it felt like it was easy.
And then the third one?
Yeah.